What's going on, buddy? Today, we're going to be playing Clannad. Clannad is based off of an anime, and I've watched it before, so I know a little bit about the details of the game. Let's just jump right into it. New game. I'll be doing the voice of the main character, and I'll be letting the Japanese dialogue go by itself. The world is covered in white. Snow. Yes, it's snow. Even now, it continues to fall, coating me in its paleness. What could I be doing here? Better yet, how long have I been here? My hand is buried in snow. It's holding on to something. I pull it out. It's a pure white hand. Yells now. A girl's hand. Oh, yeah, that's right. I wasn't alone. I wipe away the snow on her face. Her profile, sleeping peacefully, appears before me. Yes, this girl and I had always been together. Here in this world. This empty, sorrowful world. I hate this town. There's just too many memories here I'd rather forget.
So much angst in this voice right now.
Every day is the same. Go to school, see friends, come home to a place I can't stand. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will change if I keep living like this. I wonder if my life will ever change. There's nature almost everywhere you look around here. I guess today is just another day of trekking through the mountains to get to school. The trip would be so much easier if I could just level them all. If I were able to go in a straight line, I'd probably save myself 20 minutes. 20 minutes every day. How much time would that save me a year? I try to do the math in my head as I walk. I can't figure it out.
Don't worry, we're all not all good at math.
I don't see any other students from my school around. This is the main street to school, too. Normally there are students everywhere. Today isn't a vacation or anything like that, either. So I guess that means I'm late. Responsible students don't just stroll into school at this hour of the day after all. Still, I continue walking at a leisurely pace, unfazed by my realization and the deserted scene before me. 200 meters left to the school gates. I stand still for a moment. I exhale digitally while gazing up at the sky. Who put those letters in the sky? I wondered. There stand the school gates, all the way up the ridge. Whose idea was it to put a school on the top of a giant slope anyway? The hill goes on like a never-ending nightmare. There's another sigh, but one much smaller and shorter than mine. I look to my right. Girl is standing there, just as still as me. I can tell from the color of the school insignia on her uniform that she's also a third-year student. But she isn't someone familiar to me. Her short hair, that comes to just above her shoulders, flutters in the wind. She seems to be on the verge of tears. As a repeat offender of late arrivals, I'm not bothered one bit. She, on the other hand, seems far more concerned. The idea of getting to class this late must be pretty upsetting to her. She's nodding her head up and down with her eyes closed, as if she's telling herself something.
then she opens them. She stares up at the school gates.
I haven't been there yet.
Huh? Oh, she's not asking me. She's talking to somebody else. Someone in her head, I guess. I wonder how he, or perhaps she, replied. She continues to talk to herself awkwardly. You just have to find more. That's it. The girl looks at me surprised. It's almost as if she thought she was alone this whole time. Then you just have to find more things that are fun. More things that make you happy, that's all. That can't be too hard, right? The expression on her face. Ah, yes. I remember those days. What it felt like to be naive, simple. That's something we've all experienced. Come on, let's go. We start to climb the hill. The long, long hill. April 14th.
Tsunohara.
The teacher calls the student's name. I look to my side where Tsunohara's desk sits empty. His attendance rate is even worse than mine. You see, the two of us are often labeled as the delinquents at school. But that's probably why we get along so well. He's really the only person in class I can have an honest conversation with. Nevertheless, today's classes begin. I spend them looking out the window. The teacher's voices go in one ear, not the other.
What happens when you kind of turn your head this way? It goes in through one ear, so you get it.
Classes finish, bringing the school day to an end. Tsunohara never did show. In fact, the only person I've spoken to all day is that girl from this morning. It really is just another ordinary day. Since I'm not part of any after-school club, I grab my empty bag, cut through a pack of jabbering students, and leave the classroom. I could go home, but there wouldn't be anyone else there at this hour. Not anyone I'd want to see anyway. I don't have a mother. I was told that she died in a car accident when I was still little. I don't even remember what she looks like. After her passing, my father sank into a deep depression, probably due to the shock of it all. Using alcohol to numb his pain, he wasted away his days gambling. Because of that, a lot of my time as a kid was spent arguing with him, actually. But one day, our relationship took a turn for the worse. He got violent with me. I completely forgot that he was an abusive dad. Ever since then, my father stopped showing his emotions. He's also stopped calling me just Tomoyo. Tomoya. Just instead calling me Tomoya-kun, as if we're nothing more than strangers. And indeed, he's turned into just that at this point. It's like he's retreating to some kind of shell. As if he's trying to sever the present from the past. It'd be better if he'd just push me away completely, or just keep hitting me. At least then I'd know where I stand with him. But no, every time he sees me back home from school, he brightens up like an old friend is visiting and starts making small talk. It hurts. It hurts so much. I can't stand being home anymore. That's why I stay out so late now. If I come home when I know he's asleep, I don't have to see him. That's why I go to bed at dawn. Of course, then I don't wake up until noon. I've been late almost every day since starting high school. I've spent my life like this for almost 3 years now. Today's no different either. I go home just to change out of my school uniform, then leave again before my father gets back. The routine practically feels ingrained in me at this point. I wander around town aimlessly until nightfall. No matter what, I always end up at the same place. Oh my, I grab some takeout from one of the local restaurants. I carry with me as I walk down the massive hill from this morning toward the school dormitory. Our school pays special attention to its clubs, so a lot of the students come from more rural areas to enroll. Those students then live here for the next 3 years, separated from their parents. These kids are practically members of a different species when compared to someone without any academic dreams like me. Normally, I wouldn't have anything to do with them, but Sunohara lives here. He used to be on the soccer team, and was even accepted to the school because of how good he was. However, he lost his spot on the varsity team as a freshman after being suspended for getting into a huge fight with a student from another school. By the time the following new squad was decided, he was already an outcast within the team. He had no choice but to leave. He doesn't have the money to move though, so he still lives in the dorms where all the jocks are. Alright. Well, that's going to be it for episode 1 of Clannad. Stay tuned for episode 2 when we get to introduce Sunohara. Until then, bye, buddy.